Now that we have the basics of fractional exponents and radical notation down, we're going to tackle a few more challenging problems. We'll start with this one, which has both a fractional exponent and radical notation. We're going to tackle this problem two different ways. First, we're going to focus on that fractional exponent right here because we know how to handle that. That 49 is 7 squared, so we can write 49 to the 3 halves as 7 squared raised to 3 halves power. Power of a power, we know what to do there. We multiply the exponents. And we have 7 raised to the power 2 times 3 halves. 2 times 3 halves, that's just 3. So now we just have the cube root of 7 cubed. What number do you cube to get 7 cubed? You cube 7. So our answer is 7. Now there we focused on the fractional exponent first. Now let's see what happens when we focus on the radical first. We'll focus on the radical by turning it into a fractional exponent. And we know how to handle that. The cube root of any number is just that number raised to the 1/3 power. So we'll just take this and raise it up to the 1/3 power. Now once again, we have power of a power. We know what to do there. We multiply the exponents. So we have 49 to the 3 halves times 1/3. The 3's cancel off, and we're left with 49 to the 1/2 power. And of course, you multiply 7 by 7 to get 49. This is just the square root of 49. So our answer is 7. Once again, we did the same problem two different ways, got the same answer both times. We must be right. All right, let's try another one. Oh boy. Yeah, that's pretty complicated, all three of these different radical expressions. I'm going to focus on just one of them first. I'm going to focus on this 4th root of 48. We're going to try to simplify that first. 4th root of 48. Now, we simplified square roots before just by pulling out perfect square factors. Here, we're going to do something very similar, but we're going to try to pull out perfect 4th power factors. Now, 48 is just 16 times 3. 16 is 2 to the 4th. So, we're going to pull out a factor of 16, and we'll do that by breaking the 4th root of 16 times 3 into the 4th root of 16 times the 4th root of 3. Maybe you find that step a little bit fishy going from here to here. That's good. Let's see why that works. What we're really doing here is we're using one of our exponent rules. I take the 4th root of 48. That's 48 to the 1/4 power. 48 to the 1/4 power. Now I can break this up as 16 times 3 to the 1/4 power. Now I have power of a product, and that's equal to a product of powers. And that's all we're doing up here, is this step right here. It's just an exponent rule. Now the 4th root of 16 coming back up here, 16 of course is just 2 to the 4th. So this is 2 times the 4th root of 3. All right, so we got that one simplified. We can go back over here and write this as 2 times the 4th root of 3. Okay, one down. 240. Well, now we have a plan, right? We're going to start pulling out perfect 4th power factors, but we need to figure out what perfect 4th power factors go into that. So do a little scratch work here. Start off with 243. We can clearly pull out a factor of 3. 3 goes into 243, 81 times. 81, that's 3 to the 4th. 81 is 9 squared, 9 is 3 squared, 81 is 3 to the 4th. So the 4th root of 243 is the 4th root of 81 times 3, which is the 4th root of 81 times the 4th root of 3. 4th root of 81 is 3. So this is 3 times the 4th root of 3. Okay, now 768. That's going to take some work, too. Let's see, we'll start off 768. What are we going to pull out here? I'll pull out a 2. Pull out a 2, and that'll go into there. 384. Pull out another factor of 2. And then I have 192. Pull out another factor of 2. We get 96. What's going on here? 2, pull out another factor of 2. We get 48 again. We've already dealt with 48. Ah, check this out. So if we start out with the fourth root of 768, we get the fourth root of 2 to the fourth, got all these 2s, times 48. And that is the fourth root of 2 to the fourth times the fourth root of 48. Now, the fourth root of the 2 to the fourth, of course, that's just 2. And we already figured out that the fourth root of 48 is 2 times the fourth root of 3. So this all just comes out to be 4 times the fourth root of 3. And now we've simplified the fourth root of 768 to just 4, that's an ugly 4, times the fourth root of 3. Now we can simplify this because we have the same radical notation, the same radical expression here, the fourth root of 3, in all three of these. We can factor it out. We factor it out and we write this as 2 plus 3 minus 4 times the fourth root of 3. All we're doing here is factoring out the fourth root of 3. And you can check that by distributing out this product, multiplying this back out, you'll get this. Now this is easy to compute. 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 minus 4 is 1. So this simply comes out to the fourth root of 3. So this is a ridiculous way to say the fourth root of 3. All right, we got that one down. One more. All right, here's our last problem. Huh. Well, this side's simple enough. That side's easy to deal with. But these, Well, I can start off by writing this as 2 to the n. Well, I can get rid of the radical notations. Radical notation's kind of confusing here because I don't know how to combine a cube root and a square root. But I can write the cube root of 4 as just 4 to the 1/3, and I can write the square root of 32 as 32 to the 1/2 power. So that doesn't scare me as much, because I know how to combine expressions when I'm dealing with exponents. And we're multiplying, we just add the exponents, but the base has to be the same to add the exponents. So I can't just add the 1/3 and the 1/2 here. I need the base to be the same. And I really like it to be 2, because in the end, I need something that looks like 2 to the n. Fortunately, 4 and 32 are both powers of 2. When you're dealing with problems like this, with exponents, with lots of different exponents, you get everything with the same base. Sometimes it makes things a lot easier. So I'm going to take that 4 and write it as 2 squared. And I'm going to take that 32. 32 is 16 times 2. 16 is 2 to the 4th. 32 is 2 to the 5th. And that's raised up to the 1/2 power. Now we have power of a power. We multiply the exponents. This is 2 to the 2/3. And over here we have 2 to the 5/2. Just multiplying those two exponents. Now the bases are the same. So now bases are the same and we're multiplying here. We add the exponents. This is 2 to the 2/3 plus 5/2. Now we're going to need a common denominator there. This is 2 to the 4/6 plus 15/6. And finally, we have 2 to the 19/6. We're looking for the value of n. Now it's easy to compare these two and see that our value of n is 19/6, and we're done.